Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about scanning electron microscope. It's also called SEM-SEM. So scanning electron microscope is very important type of electron microscope. In my previous video, I complete discuss about electron microscope. So I recommended that video you go watch first for better understanding the concept. So electron microscope is basically two type. It's SEM and TEM, scanning electron microscope and transmission electron microscope. In this particular video, we complete discuss about SEM, scanning electron microscope. So basic introduction of SEM is, it is a type of electron microscope, uses electrons to illuminate a specimen and create an enlarged image. So this is the basic introduction of SEM. Depth resolution of SEM is 10 to 100 nanometer. Its lateral resolution is 1 to 10 nanometer. Magnification power is 10 to 5 lakh x. So this is the basic important point about scanning electron microscope. Now the principle is very important for our semester exam point of view, and it is scanning electron microscope is basically very important for our competition exam point of view, as well as very important for MSc second semester examinations. So principle of scanning electron microscope is, the theory portion of principle is, the signals used by a scanning electron microscope to produce an image result from interaction of the electron beam with atom at various depth within the sample. Various type of signals are produced. So this is the basic theory portion of principle. So what is the basic principle that work is, we use electron beam in scanning electron microscope. Electron beam bombarded to the sample, the atoms and electron beam, when atom of sample and electron beam is interact, three types of signal are produced. So this is the basic principle that's work. In that principle, scanning electron microscope is work. So three types of signals are produced, that is secondary electrons, backscatter electron, emitted X-ray protons. So these three types of signals are collected and surface of the specimen in image in 3D and black and white. So we got 3D image in this scanning electron microscope. For using this electron microscope, we got 3D image. When we use TEM, transmission electron microscope, we got 2D image. So this is the basic difference between SEM and TEM. So this is the theory portion of principle. Now from diagram we understood very well of that principle is that it is our specimen or sample. When radiation source electron beam is bombarded to a specimen or our sample, three types of signals are produced, that is secondary electron, backscatter electron, and emitted X-ray and also transmitted electron. In our next video, transmission electron microscope, we study about transmitted electrons. So three types of signals are produced, that is secondary electron, backscatter, and emitted X-ray. So this is the basic principle scanning electron microscope in this using this principle. Now the instrumentation part of this scanning electron microscope is very important. So when we are going to discuss about the instrumentation of SEM, we have to know about the every single parts of that instrumentation. So we study its instrumentation by its study by every parts of that instrument. So we use electron source, electron beam, anode, condenser lens, objective lens, scanning coil, and this is the motorized stage in which we use sample or specimen. This is the secondary electrons, backscatter electron, and X-ray detector. This all signals are we got after electron beam bombarded to sample. So what is the electron source? What is the electron beam? So for electron source, we use electron gun. Electron gun is basically defined by, so electron gun contain tungsten filament, 1 to 30 kilowatt accelerating voltage is applied to produce the electron beam. So basically electron gun is used to produce the electron beam. It is very important. And Anode is very important. Working of anode, it is positively charged and attract the negatively charged electron, and ultimately this anode will accelerate the velocity of the electron. So basically it's anode's main work of anode is accelerate the electron beam. So it is very important. And the important point, one of the very important point, is that electron beam is controlled by anode. Electron beam is basically controlled by anode. Condenser lens and objective lens and lenses, these are electromagnetic lenses. So two types of lenses we use is condenser lens and objective lens, and these both lens are electromagnetic lenses. So the basic work of condenser lens and objective lens are, so condenser lens, what is work of that condenser lens is, this lenses will focus the electron beam toward the objective lens. So basically electron gun produce the electron beam, anode is accelerated, then condenser lens focus electron beam toward the objective lens. Then objective lens, this lens will again focus the electron beam toward the sample or specimen. So this is the basic work of condenser and objective lenses. When electron beam are bombarded to sample. Okay, so before we are going to study the sample principal working of that instrument, we have to know about the sample preparation. So sample preparation is also very important. So what is the sample preparation? First, we have to clean our sample, then dry, then dehydration. For dehydration, we use acetone and alcohol, then coat it and fixation. Okay, this microscope cannot be used to image living cell because we do the dehydration of that particular sample. That's why we don't use the image living cell in this microscope. So this is our dehydrated sample, and electron beam is bombarded in them. Three types of signal we got. First is secondary electron, backscatter electron, and X-ray detection. So in SAM, so one of the very important point is that before we are going to discuss about the secondary electron, we have to know about that point is, in SAM, raster scan generator is used for live scanning, and it will help to complete scanning of the surface of a specimen. So we use a raster scan generator to live scanning of that sample. So what is the secondary electron? When we got our first signal is secondary electron. So secondary electron is basically detection of SAM. So it is a very important detection of SAM is, secondary electron are most abundant in the case of SAM and detected by suitable detector. Everhart Thornley or ET detector is most commonly used detector for detection of secondary electron in SAM. ET detector contain biased grid which is positively charged to attract the secondary electron. Secondary electron detected by ET detector will produce the basic imaging of SAM. So this is the basic introduction, basic important theory portion of secondary electron or SE detection. So what is the secondary electron detected by ET detector? And it is the most abundant in this case of SAM, and secondary electron detected by ET detector will produce the basic imaging of SAM. So secondary electron is produce the basic imaging of SAM. Our second detection in SAM is backscatter electron. It is one of the very important signal. So energy of backscatter electron SES are higher than secondary electron. So ET detector of varying voltage can differentiate between them. So this is the basic difference between backscatter and secondary electron. So secondary backscatter electron has higher energy than scatter electron, higher than secondary electron. Energy of backscatter electron is higher than secondary electron. And third detection in SAM is X-ray detector. Inside the sample holder, X-ray detector is placed, and it will detect the X-ray emitted by the sample. This detection process is known as EDX, or energy dispersive X-ray analysis. So this is the X-ray detection. So this is the basic function principle of electric beam are bombarded to sample. Three types of detection we got: secondary electron, backscatter electron, and X-ray detector. When three signals are using by CPU, and we got the same imaging. This is the our final product by using instrument of that same, and it is and this image has high resolution power, and this has a magnified image we got, and it is very important instrumentation to got that. And we generally use the optical microscope, but when we required higher resolution and magnified image, then we use scanning electron microscope. And this is a basic working function of this scanning electron microscope, and this is the principle of scanning electron microscope. I hope you understood what I try to explain, and it will helpful for your examinations. Now the application part of scanning electron microscope, it is very important. Application parts is, so application, first application is for investigate of virus structure, 3D tissue imaging, insect. Third is insect spore, other microorganism or cellular component visualize. And geologists often use them to learn more about crystalline structure, and industries including microelectronics, medical devices, food processing, all use SEM as a way to examine the surface compositions of component and product. So this is the basic application of SEM, and very important. I hope these notes will help for your semester exam as well as for any competition exam and your preparation in examinations. And I hope it will be helpful for you, and if you find it's helpful, so please support, like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and thank you so much for watching.